the don'ts of Cracker Barrel camping. Many Cracker Barrels from east to west allow overnight RV parking in their lots. It's not the same as Walmart. It's not the same as many other overnight parking options. And today we're gonna be sharing the unique don'ts if you want to camp overnight at a Cracker Barrel. So stay tuned. Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for being here today. Big shout out to RV Masterclass. We're teaming up with them this week to give away their signature course bundle. The giveaway includes RV Buyers Bootcamp, Preparing to Full-Time RV, and Boondocking 101, over $300 value. If you want to enter to get access to those courses, I'll put a link in the description and in the comment section. Get you signed up easily and we'll get you those courses if you win. But today's video is all about Cracker Barrel camping and what not to do if you're gonna camp at Cracker Barrel. Number one is don't always expect to park a big RV at Cracker Barrel. Walmart is known for having huge lots. Cracker Barrel, not always the case. There are a lot of Cracker Barrels that have big lots where you can park an RV that is, you know, 30, 35 feet. But there are also Cracker Barrels that allow overnight parking that only have spots behind the building that really don't have much space for anything over 25 feet. They're spots made for a Class C without a tow vehicle or a truck towing a shorter travel trailer. So whenever you're doing research about camping at a Cracker Barrel overnight, make sure you read the reviews and see what type of RVs have had success camping there, because I wouldn't just expect out of the gate that every Cracker Barrel can host very large RVs. It's not the same as Walmart in that aspect. Number two is don't overstay your welcome. Just like Walmart and just like any other overnight parking spot, you don't wanna overstay your welcome at Cracker Barrel. The good part about Cracker Barrel is that it closes down at nighttime. So there are very clear times whenever you're not getting in the way. That would be probably like somewhere around 10 at night to maybe 8 in the morning. Parking lot's gonna be pretty empty, no one's gonna be there, and you're not getting in the way of anything. Don't overstay that welcome by arriving too early while their dinner rush is happening, or by sticking around too long in the morning if people are trying to park there to get breakfast and be a patron of the business. You're only gonna wanna stay at Cracker Barrel for about 8 to 10 hours max. The next one, number three, is don't worry about having a sleep mask. We told you to worry about having a sleep mask when you go camping at Walmart because it's so bright. But to my point, that Cracker Barrel closes, it gets dark, the parking lot is not always well lit. Quite often you park in the back of a Cracker Barrel. You don't have to worry about light intrusion coming in and ruining your sleep on most cases. This is one reason why we love parking at a Cracker Barrel overnight to get some sleep, is that it's very restful, it's very quiet, and no bright lights are being shown into the RV, and we can get a good night's sleep. So don't worry about that sleep mask whenever you're camping at Cracker Barrel. Number four is don't forget a hot breakfast on the way out. This should be a no-brainer, even more so than any other overnight parking spot where maybe you just get some gas station food or some fast food. At Cracker Barrel, you can go in, sit down, drink a few cups of coffee, get ready for that next travel day, eat eggs, potatoes, whatever you want, all made to order, and you're gonna be feeling good whenever you hit the road. And also, it's a best practice, whether you eat dinner there or breakfast, that you patronize the business that's giving you free camping. So go in, and I recommend a breakfast because a full belly on the way out is always ideal. But hey, dinner is fine too. So don't forget that hot meal whenever you go to Cracker Barrel. And the number five thing not to do at Cracker Barrel is don't set up camp. You can set your slides out at Cracker Barrel more times than not, even more so than at Walmart, because the business is truly closed down overnight. The parking lot is dead and no one is coming in there. So if you do need to put the slides out, it really shouldn't be nearly as much as an issue at Cracker Barrel. But don't let that fool you to think that you can go outside and set your camping chairs up or get a little too comfy there in your campsite. Because even though you have the place to yourself in the wee hours of the night, it does pick back up early in the morning. People are probably gonna start coming in at 4 or 5 o'clock as far as the employees and the managers getting set up, and then the guests come in shortly thereafter. Don't set up anything outside. Don't get too comfy. Be respectful of that incoming morning traffic and get out of the way. You know, common sense stuff, sometimes it just bears repeating. Now, if you can't find a Cracker Barrel and you can't find a Walmart, we highly suggest trying out Harvest Hosts, because that is a membership site. I think it costs like $79 to enter, and you have access to their database for a year. But so much cooler than Walmart or Cracker Barrel is that you get to overnight park at places like wineries, vineyards, farms, museums, and they truly have a humongous database across the US. So try out Harvest Host, because if you just need some other option besides Walmart or Cracker Barrel or a truck stop or an interstate rest stop, it'll give you the most restful sleep. You'll probably feel a lot safer at those locations. And hey, you can get a glass of wine or even a bottle of wine if you're staying at a vineyard. Make that night extra special. Thank you guys for watching the video. Remember, enter that giveaway for RV Masterclass, where you get access to all 3 signature courses. The giveaway will last this week only. You can enter by following the link in the comment section or in the description. It'll be in both places. And if you want to try free camping, we'll put the free camping video up here in the left hand corner. 20 best free campsites in America. We've been to all of them. We love them all. So you might want to check that out. Try some true boondocking and free camping. Until next time, later on.